So I want to share with you the experiences of Robert Harper, who was in the World Trade Center today when it was hit by a plane. We talked earlier today when he was at a hospital and he had been treated some. Mr. Harper, how are you doing tonight?
I'm doing okay. Thanks, Tom.
Tell us exactly where you were and what you were doing when the World Trade Center was attacked.
I was outside of the World Trade Center at the point of the impact of the second airplane and had only recently come into Manhattan. I was running a little bit late, as we had talked about earlier in one of the broadcasts. And I saw the second plane hit the building. And I couldn't believe it, because at first, you know, my thought was, well, maybe it was just an accident. But then when you saw the second plane come in, it was clear, I think, to everyone that this was not a mistake. This was a clear, deliberate, malicious act, you know, that was, you know, perpetrated on the United States. And at that point, I just felt that, you know, this was a very dangerous place to be. There had been a huge fireball that came quickly after that. And I knew that, you know, it was a very dangerous place to have been today.
And so you began to run, I gather.
I did. And one of the things that I think the videos that you've shown tonight really don't reflect is that, you know, by the time those buildings started to come down, there were so many thousands of people that were down there trying to help everyone out. There were, you know, EMS workers, firemen down there, and the huge cloud of smoke. I think when someone referred to it as looking as though it was snowing down there, and that's exactly what happened. I had to take my shirt off and put it over my nose to breathe, because all of the debris that was coming down there just made it impossible to even feel like, you know, you were going to get out of there. And once the building started coming down, I was sort of over in the area near the Woolworth building, and I thought, you know, this building comes down, it's probably going to hit the Woolworth building. And I began to run, I mean, literally just run, you know, at the top speed that I could to try to get over to the bridges. But then I kept thinking, you know, whoever did this, they perpetrated this particularly to try to maybe bring down some of the other buildings. So all of the thousands of people that were on the Brooklyn Bridge, I also felt, were probably in danger. And you really had no idea which way to run, but you knew that you just had to get somewhere. So it was incredible, because I think that for the amount of people that have lost their lives today, it was just no way of knowing, you know, what you could have done then.
Where did you work in the World Trade Center, Robert?
I wasn't working in the World Trade Center, but I work on William Street, a few blocks around there. But I'd come into the area and was down there then.
Uh-huh. And what about your other coworkers? Are they okay tonight?
I hope so. I mean, as you know, the cell phones were operating off of the World Trade Center tower, so a lot of people I've lost contact with. I've tried to call a lot of people. Cell phones initially had been out of, you know, touch. I've left messages from people, and I'm just glad to hear that Mayor Giuliani has suggested that people, you know, don't come into Manhattan tomorrow, because it's been very difficult to get communication. I've tried to call to various members of my family, and, you know, they're saying that a lot of the lines have been tied up or not, you know, able to get through. So I would suspect that a lot of voicemails in that area have probably not operable now.
All right. Thank you very much, Robert Harper, who had a narrow escape today. He was just a little bit late for work, and it was a good day to be that, probably.
Absolutely.
And he was able to get out of that area, but he was witness to many of the horrors that were existing down there. In fact, New York City is a much more personal city than a lot of people realize. It's really a collection of small